In this ePanel tutorial, we're going to go through the options for navigation. So once you're in ePanel, click on Navigation in the left-hand menu. And we'll have three tabs here, one for Pages, one for Categories, and one for General Settings. If you click on Pages, you'll see the options that are available for your particular theme. The first box, we can exclude pages from the navigation bar. So if there's a page here you'd like not to appear on the navigation, just make sure you untick it so that there's an X. If you'd like to have drop-down menus enabled, make sure that's checked here. If you'd like a home link, click Enable here. This link will go back to the home page. In these options here, in Short Pages link, you can choose how you'd like the links to appear. So you can sort them by post title, menu order, date, or other identifiers in the drop-down list. You can choose the order that you'd like the links to appear, either ascending or descending, based on how you'd like them sorted. And here you can choose the number of drop-down tiers. So this is the number of tiers that appear in your navigation menu as you hover over them. So remember to click Save when you make any changes to your options. In the next tab, we've got Categories. Here you can choose which categories you'd like to appear in the navigation bar. These are categories on your blog, so you could just have the blog section and untick all of these so that they don't appear in your navigation bar, or keep them ticked so that they all appear. Here you can enable drop-down menus again for your categories. And in this section, you can hide empty categories. So therefore, if you have categories already set up but with no blog posts in them, you can choose to hide them. Here again, we have the number of drop-down tiers that are shown. These are the drop-down tiers that appear when you hover over your navigation menu. And as per the pages, you can choose how your links are sorted, either by the name of the post, ID, and other options here, and then choose whether they're listed by ascending order or descending order. And remember to click Save when you make some changes. And lastly, in the General Settings tab will be any options that are available for your navigation that will affect the whole entire site. So you can either disable the top tier drop down menu links or enable that here. So this will affect your navigation for the whole site. Remember to click Save. In the next video, we'll go through layout settings.